Thanks for joining me once again for another review. This one is for the new Storm Gravity Evolve. My layout is 5x5x3. This layout produces a good amount of shape for me, which isn't the greatest idea for me on ASIMs typically, but spec is a pretty smooth cover, so I thought the layout would balance it out. Keeping it simple, house shots at both Gage and Westridge, this just helps build consistency from video to video, which helps you develop a good understanding of how the ball is going to act for you. Here at Westridge, we use these lanes for League, so they have a few games on them, so I'm going to show you how these react on transition. The Virtual Gravity was one of the most popular balls of all time, and virtuals are still being made overseas, so with the core being an obvious winner, Storm decided to pay tribute to the OG and update it. I've been doing the 2nd, 3rd, 4th arrow progression thing for the last several videos, but 2nd arrow usually doesn't work well, especially after a little transition, but the first few shots were pretty good. My comfort zone is around 4th arrow. I have a bad shoulder and questionable mechanics, so I need the angle to help me with speed, which I don't have much of. That allows me to rev it up because I really like controlling my shapes and the ball motion. At first glance, the Evolve feels like a cross between the Virtual Gravity and Virtual Gravity Nano, and it's also kind of Halo and Sherlock-ish. It's got plenty of traction out of the box, and it blends the end of the pattern well, which is a big plus for heavy hands, but it also minimizes over-under on flatter conditions. Aside from the colors, the overall shape really screams Virtual Gravity. They got that part spot on. I think it's a little slower on friction than the original due to the cover difference. The OG had R2X Solid on it, which is a weaker cover, but that contributes to more shape usually. It feels like a Virtual Gravity though. For better or worse, or however you look at it, I don't find a ton of similarity between it and the Crux Prime. You can see the cover similarity there in the way that they handle friction. They have a very smooth read that mutes transition more than typical reactives. But for having the same cover and a fairly similar core from a numbers perspective, for me there's more definition of shape with the Evolve. Maybe it's an optical illusion due to the way the colors swirl. The Prime kind of looks like a big beach ball, but the overall traction is similar with the Prime maybe edging it out a bit, while the Evolve wins in the down lane strength department. Sometimes it can be hard to tell without throwing them both yourself, but they're different enough to be able to see in this case, I think. Another thing to note is that all the Prime footage is new footage with the original Prime that I drilled in January and have used quite a bit since then, so the cover is performing as advertised as far as I'm concerned. I know that's still a fairly small sample size, but it hasn't lost a step, so performance, durability, and longevity with the Evolve should be high. As we move to Gage, balls with surface aren't needed here and typically don't look very good here. Some lane shine help, but it's just not a good ball choice here. Shiny pearls and hybrids generally look best. I've only found a few exceptions with solids. Again, from second arrow, I have to come straight up the back and bail on it at the bottom just to get to the pocket. There's just too much friction to the right on house shots for me to get a decent roll on it. I kind of just have to chuck it. The issue with dull, solid ball reaction here is that the back ends are really strong. If I'm too far right, the ball's going to grab and go, and eventually there's a cliff where I move left to get the ball down the lane, and then all of a sudden it's too late or slow. And once the ball shines up, it gets easier length and more pop down lane, and it just helps me especially with the shape. It allows me to roll the ball without having to throw it to get it down the lane, so it helps me control the reaction better. If you want to keep the Evolve at box, you're going to need a lot of oil, volume, or speed. If you're just planning on house shot use, I'd let it lane shine. I don't think there's any need to chew up the track, and most house shots don't need this strong of a ball. Spec's a different cover too. The shape of the reaction doesn't really change much, shiny versus sanded. It just really changes how soon the ball starts up. I've had a lot of success on tougher stuff using my ProMotion with the shine on it because it's still really smooth on the back end and it blends the wet dry well, but it doesn't start up early enough that it gives me angle issues. Obviously you're going to want some surface for heavier or longer stuff, but if you're on a medium length and volume pattern, you might give it a couple shots in practice shiny before you get the pads out. I also think it's pretty obvious that the Prime, ProMotion, and Evolve are three pretty different balls that could all fit in one bag. You may not need that kind of strength altogether very often, but looking at shape, I don't see a whole lot of overlap, if any. If you've got a Halo and or a Halo Vision though, that's where you'd start to run into redundancy. Wrapping it up, Virtual Gravity or Virtual Gravity Nano fans should be excited. It's not exactly the same ball, obviously, but it's familiar and it's not so strong that you won't be able to throw it. The Gravity Evolve releases on October 25th with the All Road. Thanks for watching.